To the Hit Radio Morning Show. I'm Kerry Hines. It is Tuesday morning, March 3rd, 2015. It's about 6:04 in the morning. And Miss Yate, are you there?
Yes, I am. Good morning.
Well, good morning and back at ya. It is early today. You know, I'm so happy to welcome all of our wonderful listeners to the Hit Radio Morning Show. Each day, I am Kerry Hines, and with me on the line is Miss Yate, and it's Tuesday. So before we get into the, you know, all the wonderful things that we got to go through today, what was your Monday evening like? Don't say quiet and unresourceful.
No,
really?
Actually, okay. It wasn't. Remember I told you that some people don't know that I'm kind of handy around the house.
Yes.
And I have my own set of tools.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Well, I had another small project I did, so.
Okay.
I worked on that.
Now, do you like the power tools, like the drills and all of that, or just the old-fashioned hammer and those types of things?
I'll just say this. I have the power drill, the hammer, the level, everything. Well, I can't say everything because I don't have enough space for everything. But I have enough to keep her around the house.
Well, you know, I know absolutely nothing about tools and stuff. So after you've, you know, since you mentioned all those, I have nowhere else to go with this.
Okay,
I know nothing else about tools, so we're going to move along.
All
well,
right,
listen,
no problem.
Good, yes. Now, good morning to all of you guys out there. And we're so happy to have you with us on the Hair Radio Morning Show. It is show number 42. Now, I've got some great news coming up. But first, we're going to take down. We're going to tell you what the rundown is for today. And if it's your first time joining us, we want to welcome you. From 6 to 7 o'clock, we really kind of do what? We do kind of like a host chat, I think we call it.
Yes, host chat. You know, mm-hmm. Do the Let Your Spirit Soar, do our Purple Body workout and hot topics. And
then music, of course.
Music. You can't forget music.
Can't get the music. An integral part of what we do. And then in the 7 o'clock hour, we usually feature whatever the feature is going to be for the day. And today we will be featuring some of our wonderful interviews that we've had on the show, or some, and we have some that will surprise you. So we'll be getting those on, some of the fan favorites today. And just going to be a fun show. We've got some great big announcements. We opened up the show today. We actually opened up the broadcast with, I don't know if you heard the song, but it's Finally. And this is a big, well, it certainly was a big, big, big record at the time. And Finally actually was, it has been all these years performed by this extraordinary talent by the name of CeCe Peniston. And I'm so excited to have CeCe and to welcome CeCe to the all-new Hair Radio Morning Show. And CeCe, she's done my show in the past. It wasn't the Hair Radio Show. I used to host an entertainment program years ago called Center Stage, and she was my very first guest on that program. And it was my, I mean, I'd been on radio and interviewed, you know, like Fluff the Bear, like animal, you know, kids' stories and animals out in Hollywood. But when I came back east and created the Center Stage program, she was my very first guest and was just fantastic and just an extraordinary person. So I'm so proud and happy to welcome her to my new project and what we're doing here. So should be fun.
Awesome. That's awesome.
Is that not awesome? And she is just as nice and beautiful in person, even more so than what people have seen. So I can't wait. We're really, really excited. And we'll have some updated information about when she'll be with us. And then coming up next on the 13th for the 50th broadcast, we're going to host the one person we do know will be joining us is the former singer. Well, actually, he was with the group The Gap Band, and his name is Dorian Paul Williams. So we're really excited to have him here on the Hair Radio Morning Show. He's been on Hair Radio. He's been with me on Hair Radio before in the past. So he'll be returning to us and he'll be on our show. So we're really, really excited. All the wonderful celebrities, all the great singers and actors and people, you know, they're starting to come through our doors and we're quite pleased. So
wow.
I'm real happy about that.
Right.
Is that not great? So enough of those announcements. We usually kick in with some kind of music, kind of to get people going, and then we usually come back and do our workout routine. Well, first we come back and we do our Let Your Spirit Soar segment, and we've got a great one for you today. So we're going to kind of just get people up, and I'm trying to say, I think folks want to get a little bit moving this morning. So, you know, why don't we do a little bit more, CeCe? This is one of our other big hits. I think you'll recognize it. Stay with us, everybody.
I'm not afraid to
You're listening to...
Hi, this is Pearl Walker, a.k.a. the Hair Diva, and I'm calling from Memphis, Tennessee. I listened to Hair Radio this morning for the first time. It was early in the morning. I did not know what to expect, but it was a great show. It was so professionally done and laid out. And the reason why I continued to listen is because I saw this post on Facebook where they were going to be doing this tribute to Bobby Christina and her family, bless her heart, in regard to their music, the wonderful music that they have put out over the years. And I'm a Bobby Brown fan from way back. I consider myself as an original Bobby Brown fan, and I just appreciate the sensitivity that the host, Carrie, brought to the topic and the tribute. Over the years, Bobby Brown has gotten a lot of negative publicity, but I just felt that he handled it very professionally, and he used some positive language in regard to how he referred to Whitney and Bobby. He called them both superstars, saying that Bobby Christina had superstar parents, and I had never heard them referred to like that collectively. And the show had different guests on it, and it was very informative, and I could tell that it was very well organized, and I enjoyed it. I posted something about it on my page, and I will continue to tune in and tell others about it, but I definitely did enjoy it, and I will be tuning in again to Hair Radio.
All right, we're back live. You're listening to the Hair Radio Morning Show. I'm Carrie Hines. It is Tuesday morning, March 3rd, 2015. Ms. Tate, are you there?
Yes, I am, this beautiful Tuesday morning.
Well, it is, and just on the screen, you know, the computer is, we had a little bit of an issue in which the it's just a little bit moving a little bit slowly in terms of, you know, so there may be some unexplainable pauses in between, but you know that, you know, whatever we have planned should be coming up. So, yeah, it's a little bit of a gap for us this morning, which is a little odd because we want things to be Instamatic here, if that's the right word. I don't even know if that's a word anymore. Didn't they used to have the Instamatic cameras? Remember those?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, and Instamatic.
We graduated.
Yes, we have. And what's so funny
come
is
a long
that
way.
We have, and Instamatic can't possibly be as Instamatic as the cell phone cameras or whatever. You know, that's, I mean, if we thought the old stuff was Instamatic, can you imagine what they would call this stuff now? You know,
by
comparison.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Mm. So lots of things. Lots of good things to get to today as well. So let's go ahead. We'll knock out the Let Your Spirit Soar segment. I'm going to see if we can get these tracks and things to play nice today and kind of help us out here. So the Let Your Spirit Soar segment, and you know, this is the time that we kind of load up our wonderful music track for the Let Your Spirit Soar segment. So let's take a look and see if we can make things happen with that. Okay, so great. It's going to cooperate, so we're doing okay on that one. we are. Well, it's one track at a time in radio. So let me, why don't you be kind enough to tell everybody what the Let Your Spirit Soar segment is all about, Ms. Yate?
Sure, I'd be glad to. The Let Your Spirit Soar segment is designed to uplift, encourage, provide introspection, and ignite within one's spirit the desire to aspire to greatness.
Wow. Very deep, as I say to you every day about this time. And today's Let Your Spirit Soar segment, it goes like this. It says, limitations live only in our minds. But if we use our imagination, our possibilities become limitless. And that's by Jamie Paolinetti. Again, it says, limitations live only in our minds, but if we use our imaginations, our possibilities become limitless. Jamie Paolinetti, yeah. Now, what does that mean to you, Ms. Yate? And then I'll go ahead and jump on in.
Well, like the heart, you know, it's the center of the emotional state where we, you know, we feel, we kind of have all our senses there. So I take that as an example for the heart. I'm sorry, the mind. And with the mind, you know, everything is processed, is perceived, it's imagined, we visualize, you know, that's a center for creation. So when I look at it in that comparison, it's one of those things, if we limit that, then we limit the source. So when we take the limits off and really, really use our imagination, because that's where everything stems, when you see the things that we have today, it started from somewhere. So if we can take the limits off of that and fully use and exercise our imagination, then it is limitless. The possibilities are limitless.
Wow. Well, I agree with that. I look at it that, you know, very simply, the only thing that kind of can stop you with in terms of creativity and creative spirit is what you believe will stop you. So, you know, anything is possible if you conceive it. And I usually kind of, I'm always inspired by these wonderful Let Your Spirit Soar segments, because each day we tend to pick out things that are inspirational and inspiring. So it's kind of nice. And usually the things that kind of resonate with me are things that talk about what's possible and what the imagination can conceive. So those are the things that kind of really kind of get me going. And yeah, but let's hear from some of our listeners. And what's our wonderful hashtag that folks can write into, and they can tweet us at Hair Radio. But one of the hashtags is Hair Radio 20.
Yeah, that's HAIRADIO 20. And of course, Carrie Hines.
Yeah. That's true. So yeah, you guys, let us know what you think about the, you know, the Let Your Spirit Soar segments. Of course, you can see all of our wonderful Let Your Spirit Soar segments listed at hairradio.com. There's a whole tab there that speaks to all the different wonderful quotes and things that we use daily, pretty much right here on the Hair Radio Morning Show. Plus, there's another some wonderful updates while you're there. We've added some fan pages, some of our recent guests. They're all there. Plus, there's some great stories. There's also a big update about the month of March is there, and some of the upcoming celebrity guests as well. So there's a lot of stuff there to check it out. Just kind of keeping things moving along a little bit as we kind of start to look at, you know, what we'll be doing today. Anything big for you, Ms. Yate?
Well, I'm going to get out and work with my middle schoolers today. So I'm pretty excited about that.
Oh, that sounds wonderful. All right.
Yeah.
Well, maybe this will get things moving along a little bit. Let's see if we can get it to play. I think we'll be okay. So we'll keep our fingers crossed. It'll probably just pop on in. And that's what we'll do. We'll toss in some music. We're going to see. There may be, like I said, a slight delay in some cases. But that's all right. Stay with us.
Stand by. heart was standing tall.
You make when you remove your hat? Well, the ladies at Natural Born Hats have created a solution for the dreaded hair pull. These hats are not only fashionable, but they've been created to protect your hair as well. All hats are made with an inner layer of polyester and a satin finish, guaranteed to prevent breakage and moisture retention. Natural Born Hats are not just for the ladies. They're for every age, race, and gender. Natural Born Hats will protect you from the elements with style. Contact us at naturalbornhats.com.
Here with the Hop of Fleecy Dot, I'm the Holistic Hair Healer. Have you ever wondered how, as a professional stylist, that you can get better at cornrows or even learn the concept of braidless weaving to assist your clients better and in a natural way? Our certificate programs and courses offer you the opportunity to not only increase and advance your skills, but improve your health and that of the people you interact with. To find out more about our classes, certificate programs, structurally enhanced water, known as Dr. Brown's Healing Water, and the Fleecy Dot signature line, which includes Fleecy Dot Hair Sugar, please contact us at 973-619-2855 or 201-921-9894. We look forward to hearing from you soon.
All right, we're back live. You're listening to the Hair Radio Morning Show. I'm Carrie Hines. It is Tuesday, March 3rd, 2015. About 6:30 in the morning. Miss Yate, are you there?
Yes, I am.
All right. Well, listen, I just want, if you've just joined, it's having a little bit of a technical issue. So if you hear some slight delays in tracks playing with music or commercials and things like that, we're working on it. But it's going to, you know, it might affect us here and there. So don't be alarmed about it and just hang in there with us and we should keep things moving along. So today we were just talking about, before we went to the commercial break, about some of the things and you're looking forward to getting out there and being amongst all the kids and so forth today. And you guys who are just joining us, yes, Yate, you're in Jacksonville, Florida.
Yes, I am.
We're in New York. Weather, sunshine. I was about to ask you. I haven't checked in on the weather. How are you guys doing weather-wise these days?
Actually, we're doing pretty good. Yesterday, it got up to about 76.
I'm serious.
Today, it's 64 right now. It's supposed to get up to about 77. However, it's supposed to rain later in the week, and then, of course, it'll, get cooler. But that's how it is here.
I can't believe it's that warm down there.
Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. 76?
Yes.
That's like short weather. Shorts and slipper weather. It's almost water weather.
Yes. Well, we're going to be transitioning into the spring here soon. So
this early?
We're in Florida. we might have a few more cold days. However, it's going to start heating up a little bit. We'll see the pollen and all of that good stuff. So.
Okay. You do realize for us, this is like, it's quite amazing. by contrast, and, today is 23, and I consider that to be just marvel.
Okay.
Well, yeah.
I won't say anything.
No, we're done with you. And that's the thing. It's so funny because it's, right now it's 23 degrees. We're live 6:32 in the morning. And it's so funny because some days we start broadcasting, and like I say, it's 2 or 3 degrees. That's it. Not 23. We get one digit or the other. So it's fantastic that we got both of them today. And some mornings I start the show and it's, like I said, it's 3 degrees. And within minutes, it's down to 2. So it is just brutally cold. I mean, this has been a crazy weather season up here up north. But you know what? But we hang on in there.
We really do.
Well, listen, we've got a lot of updates to tell everybody about today. Now, coming up between 7 and 8, we're going to have some of our featured stylists. I also want to let folks know that Dr. Praneek James will be back with us. She is the trichologist, and she'll be sharing a lot of, this time around, she'll be handling calls from the folks out there, from you guys. So we're so excited to have her back on the show. And I have something I want her to clear up for us. One of the listeners had sent in something, and I want to, I'll be addressing that. We may do it on air, so we want you to, stay tuned for that and just remind me when it comes time to get Dr. Praneek James on the air. So she'll be with us very, very soon, and we're happy about that. And as I mentioned, we've got Dorian Williams from the Gap Band will be with us to help us celebrate our 50th broadcast, which is our virtual broadcast. Let me just sip some water here. So, Ms. Yate, tell us about those T-shirts.
I thought you was going to come back and say something else. That's all right. Yes, we have the new shirt out. It's called It's Not Just Hair, It's Us. Our hair, our health, and our heritage. And it's in reference to the natural hair community, but more importantly, it's to support a community outreach, which we've partnered with haircares.org. Mm-hmm. And we're looking forward to making some changes, some impactful changes in the community via the hair industry, barbers and stylists alike. So we want to kind of take what we have and contribute in that manner.
Yes. I agree. And thank you so much. And this is so important for us. And we're going to keep, we're going to be checking in with you regarding these great shirts and some other ideas that we're moving forward. We're going to just take a quick music break. Now, this is kind of an extended song. I'm going to just get some water here. And we've got to move things along with the Radio Morning Show. So, folks, stay with us. We do have a big show for you coming up on this Tuesday. So, stay with us. Okay. And it's averaging about 10 to 20 seconds delay. All right, folks, stay with us. Thank you. Hi, you're listening to the Hair Radio Morning Show. I'm Carrie Hines. It is great to have you with us on this Tuesday, March 3rd, 2015. Miss Yate, I want to thank you for being with us as well today.
Sure, sure. It's a pleasure.
Yeah, so I'm noticing the tracks are running about 10 to 20 seconds behind, so it's okay for you to stay with us if you hear any strange technical concerns we'll say this morning, but we will get through it. The show must go on, as they say in the business, so we're all happy about that part. I do want to remind everybody, we generally want to kind of move on to what our secret word of the day is. And I think this is going to be just fantastic. The secret word, you know, and maybe Yate, you can tell the folks a little bit about the secret word as well.
Sure, sure. The secret word is a word that's put out by Mr. Carrie Hines during the hours, of 6 to 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And you have to send in the word before we go off air in order to get your 5 points
in
your rewards bucket. If you aren't a rewards member, then you must sign up. And with that, you'll get an additional, 1,000 points? 1,000
points? That's right. That's right.
That's a lot of points.
That's a great deal of points. Exactly.
Yes,
thank you.
Great deal of points. Mm-hmm. Which go toward the items that our sponsors send that we're able to share with our listening audience. So a lot of great things that you can be privy to with those Hair Radio reward points.
Exactly. Yeah. That's a very good point and well said. Correct. You want to send your secret word in to us via email. And send that to secretword@hairradio.com. And you can do that as soon as you hear the announcement of the secret word. You want to send it in to us before 9 o'clock, before we go off the air from the live edition. So, you know, make sure and send that in to us via email before 9 a.m. And as long as we get it, you'll be credited 5 bonus points in your Hair Radio Rewards membership bucket. And that's a great bucket to fill because you'll be able to, as Yate was saying, exchange those wonderful points for great gift items and also be able to participate in a lot of the Hair Radio Rewards membership program, partners programs, if you will. So a lot of folks who are providing discounts and special offers to only or exclusively, we say in radio and marketing and broadcasting and all that stuff, exclusively. To the listeners of the Hair Radio Morning Show. So you need to be a Hair Radio Rewards member in order to take advantage of that. Really good stuff. Now, the secret word of the day, inspire. Inspire.
Yeah.
I-N-S-P-I-R-E. Like you feel inspiration. You're inspired to do something. I-N-S-P-I-R-E is the secret word of the day. So make sure and get that into us via email. Now, don't misspell it. You won't qualify. Okay, so that's important. Spelling counts here for the secret word of the day. And also, am I right? Remember, and you're a teacher, so you know spelling counts.
Yes. Yes, it does.
All right. And for you guys out there, you can always text Hair Radio to 292929. And when you send that to us, again, that's 292929, we're able to automatically connect you with updates and so forth. So as we send out text messages about the show, you're going to know first who the guests are and all of that. Now, coming up, I like that idea. You're like a VIP listener, if you will.
That's
so,
it.
Yeah.
You get all the perks. All the perks.
You get
part of the
Hair Radio, kind of like the Hair Radio family.
Yes, yes. That's what I was going to say. Thank you. because I get the fans, and I'm like, okay, well, they know they're fans. It's become family now.
Uh-huh. Well, you know what? We're going to do, we're not waiting all the way to Thursday to do a toss-back song. We're going to do a throwback Tuesday today. Because I want to hear some of these wonderful songs. You know, and I think our listeners would appreciate the same thing this morning, some the fans of the Hair Radio Morning Show. And when we come back, we're going to kind of get into some of the other topics and things and some of the things that are going on of the day and talk about hairradionewspaper.com. So be part of the conversation. Go to hairradionewspaper.com. We're going to, right now, we're going to just take a music break with the one and only Miss Natalie Cole. Let's see if we can get this moving right away. Okay, it may take about 10. Okay, there we go.
Tonight, I just want to talk to the ladies. Oh, fellows, you're cruel, but girls, if you got a good man, you'd better keep him. Oh, I know you're saying right now, what does she know? Who is she to tell me about my situation? Well, I don't know your situation, but whatever it is, you should try to stay together. You know that big argument that you had the other night, remember? Well, today it's not nothing. Just don't let them leave you, honey. So then you'll find out that it wasn't those real big things you loved about him. It was the real small things. Go on and laugh, but it's true. You know, things that you've seen 1,000 times around the house but never paid any attention to. Like helping with the groceries and helping in the yard and painting and repairing and paying the bills. But you know, now all I have is memories and regrets. I could have given our love a chance to grow, but no. I had to challenge it and be heard. Let me tell you something. That female liberation stuff. I don't know, sometimes I don't think it's worth it. And I'm really feeling. Feeling kind of bad, y'all. I'm catching hell. Living here alone. I never realized, oh Lord, that you mean so much to me. I'm catching hell. I'm catching hell.
say somebody told me that it's you got something that's good to you and you don't use it, you might lose. So girl, hold on to your good things and don't let go.
Oh my God, can you believe it?
Wow.
I think they were still the Jackson 5.
Oh,
but
my.
we shot Richard Pryor for Essence magazine.
Wow.
We shot Denzel Washington the first time he was on the cover of Essence magazine.
Wow.
And but Bobby, I was working for Bobby, and 6 months after I started working for him, he fired me.
Oh, my.
He fired me.
But you had what you needed to have at that point to move on.
Well, we hope so, because I've been doing it now for almost 20 years.
Well, yes, and you absolutely got it.
Yeah, his makeup artist came to me and asked me if I would represent her.
Wow.
And that's how I started representing makeup, hair, and fashion style. She was my first makeup artist. Then I picked up a hairstylist. I picked up a fashion stylist, Michelle Cole, who is now a big costume designer in Hollywood. Mm-hmm. And that's how it all started.
Wow. Well, folks, in case you've just logged in, you're listening to the Hair Radio Show. I'm Carrie Hines. We've got some great people that we like to introduce to you from time to time. And the person we're speaking with right now is absolutely no exception to that. Her name is Crystal Wright. Now, a lot of you out there know her already. She is the artistic director of the Crystal Agency, and her website, of course. Well, you know what, Crystal, why don't we have you tell the folks out there how to contact you?
The website for the Crystal Agency is, of course, www.crystalagency.com.
Terrific. Now, I want to go back. We had started to talk a little bit about the book, and I do mean that this is the Bible of the hair and makeup and fashion styling industry, as far as I'm concerned, and many of the other folks out there. And it's called Crystal Wright's Hair, Makeup, and Fashion Styling Career Guide. And I want you to tell the folks out there about the book.
This book, it's funny because it actually is considered the Bible. A lot of schools use the book as sort of the business part of their makeup programs. And it's used actually in New York City at the Fashion Institute of Technology at FIT.
Sure.
It's used as the textbook for their fashion styling course there and in Atlanta, at Bodder, and the International Academy of Design in Florida. And this is a book that I wrote because I used to stay on the phone all day, people calling me up asking me, you know, how do I put my portfolio together? What is meant by testing with photographers? How do I get tear sheets? You know, what's a comp card? How many images should I have? All these questions that they had about building a portfolio so they could do, you know, makeup, hair, or fashion styling for television shows and films, music videos, of course, CD covers, and magazines. And the reason it's the hair, makeup, and fashion styling career guide is because hair, makeup, and styling people are completely dependent upon one another for the image that's produced.
Mm-hmm.
A makeup artist who does great makeup and is working with a hairstylist that doesn't do good hair, the only thing you produce is a bad picture. You've got to have great makeup, you have to have great hair, and you have to have great fashion styling altogether. And so the book really just talks about the business aspects of working behind the scenes. You know, what size should your portfolio be? What kind of pages should it have? How many pictures do you need to have before you go out to get an agent to represent you? In a place like New York, they have over 80 or 90 agencies that just represent makeup, hair, and fashion styles, and a lot of people don't even know it.
That's right. Good point. But just to let the folks know exactly, because this, as we were saying, is considered the Bible in the industry. Now, your book, again, is Crystal Wright's Hair, Makeup, and Fashion Styling Career Guide. It's all you need to know about getting work behind the scenes in print, video, film, and television, working with record labels, magazines, and production companies, testing with photographers, building a strong portfolio, and signing with an agency. Now, you just mentioned, in fact, being right here in New York, you're absolutely right. I mean, I thought it was over 100 of these, type of agencies, so to speak, out there. And a lot of folks, you're absolutely right, are just not aware of that. So how do we get the artists that are out there, the makeup artists, the fashion styling folks, the hair people, how do we get them more involved and in tuned with what's really happening in the industry, in the real industry? Any advice?
You know, one of the things that's really, really important is for people to step outside of their world in the salon. What they do in the salon and what you do when you're working behind the scenes are two completely different things. and you have to see them as different. What a woman needs when she's going to work every day, as far as her hair is concerned, is one thing. What a woman, how a woman wants to look when she goes to church is one thing. How a woman looks on the cover of a magazine and inside when you start putting all these fabulous clothes on them or something else. And the thing that I tell people is to begin by understanding the language of this business. Begin by reading the fashion magazines and not just looking at the hair. When you look at a fashion magazine, you've got to look at the hair, look at the makeup, look at the clothes, and look at the photography. You educate yourself by starting to understand that all of those elements together make a good picture, and if one of them is wrong, it doesn't work. And so when you look at the magazines, you got to look at Vogue, you got to look at Elle, you got to look at Glamour, you have to look at Essence, you got to look at W, and you also have to look at the European magazines and understand that you need to go back further than what happened last week on Britney Spears' music video. Because that does not give you a historical perspective. You've got to go 10 years back, 20 years back, so that when you get on a photo shoot with an editor and she says, oh, my God, let's see, I want to do a 70s spin on, a 70s spin on this model, but we want to bring her forward to the 21st century. What does that mean?
Right, exactly. Got to know what that actually means, what they're saying.
Got to know, that's right. You have to understand the influences of the 70s, the influences of the 60s, and, you know, what is meant by psychedelic and all of those kinds of things, because when you understand those things and you can reach back and pull some of those elements forward and add them to what's going on right now, that's the thing that separates you from everybody else.
Absolutely. Well, you, again, if you've just logged in and you're kind of catching us in the middle here, I'm Carrie Hines. You're listening to the Hair Radio Broadcast Network, and our very special guest who's on the line is Crystal Wright. Again, Crystal Wright's book is called Hair, Makeup, and Fashion Styling Career Guide. And we're talking with Crystal. And again, welcome to Hair Radio.
Thank you. I'm so happy to be here.
Well, it's great to have you. I mean, we get questions all the time. And probably, and you kind of touched on a little bit, probably the biggest question is, what is the first step I take? I want to get a little bit deeper. This is from the professionals. I want to get more into the industry. I want to be, dealing with the videos, working for the videos. What should I do? What's the first thing I should do? And I want to say they should buy your book. But we'll,
well, I'll let you tell it, Carrie.
Okay, no problem. And again, you really do need to
pick
this book up.
But you're right, actually. Getting the book is a great first step. Because the book has, step by step, this is what you need to do.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll tell you, the first thing that they need to do is they need to educate themselves about photography so that they know what they like and what they don't like. And the only way that you can do that, it's like you don't have to go take a photography class, but what you do have to do is start looking at the magazine so you start to recognize what kinds of photographers and what kind of photography you like. Because the next thing you have to do is you got to find photographers to work with.
Yes, exactly. Now, how difficult is that?
It's not that difficult because there are so many schools out there. I mean, if you're talking about New York, you've got the Art Institute, you've got... off the top of my head, there are two or three...
No, you're absolutely right. I'm sorry to interrupt you, but you're absolutely right. Here in New York, we have tons of wonderful places. But now, for some of our listeners who are probably logged in right now in Boise, Idaho.
Oh, it doesn't matter. That's the great thing.
Wow.
There are photography schools all over the place. There are, standalone photography schools where that's all they teach, but also a lot of times the community colleges in your area have photography classes. There's, universities have photography classes, community colleges have photography classes, there are photography workshops. The thing to do is to go to the website, go to Google, put in photography schools plus whatever the city is that you're living in plus whatever the state is, and you will find photography schools. You simply go to the schools or you call the schools up and you ask them, first of all, do you have a system for setting up, for hooking up makeup and hair people and styling people with your photographers who are willing to work with the photographers to get pictures for their portfolios?
Mm.
Okay? If that doesn't doesn't work, go to the school. Don't forget, a school, you can just walk on anytime you want. Just walk on. You know, ask where the photography classes are held. Go there. Introduce yourself to the professor. Let them know, hey, I'm a hairstylist. I'm working on my portfolio because I want to do work in the entertainment industry, or I want to do work in advertising. Uh-huh. And I was wondering if you had any photographers here who are people shooters. That's very important. Mm. You don't want to get hooked up with a photographer that's shooting cups and saucers. That's a still life photographer. You want a photographer that's shooting people and working on his or her book.
Mm-hmm.
Hook up with them. Let them know you want to build your portfolio. The thing to understand is that when you're working with a photographer, it's a collaboration. No money changes hands. You are not supposed to pay the photographer to take pictures. That's a big problem, particularly in the African-American community, where the hairstylists think that they have to go out and pay a photographer to take pictures. But in truth, in the entertainment industry, you go out and find a photographer, it's a collaboration. Everybody comes together with their skills to put something on film that they can put in their portfolios and go out and show to other people.
Beautifully said.
So it doesn't matter whether you're in Seattle or Idaho
or
Philadelphia,
where.
Go to the Internet. Find the photography schools, go introduce yourself to the professor, introduce yourself to the photographers as they're coming out of classes.
Absolutely. Well, I think you said it best, Crystal. And again, we want to tell the folks out there, they can always go to your website and get in contact with you or find out some more information. Again, what's your website, Crystal?
The agency website is crystalagency.com, and then we also have an informational website, which is makeuphairandstyling.com, and the and is spelled out. So if they want to see, you know, what we do at the Crystal Agency, just go to www.crystalagency.com, and that'll let them see the artists that we represent. And if they want just more information on the industry in general, go to makeuphairandstyling.com.
Now, we know that you represent the who's who out there in California. Anybody standing out that you might want to speak about, or any, you know, anyone in particular, or tell us about some of the folks that you represent out there, or maybe.
You know, we actually represent people out here in Los Angeles, and we have a couple of people that we represent in New York.
Oh, really?
Uh-huh. We actually represent a fabulous hairstylist that we're very excited about in New York. His name is Clark Vincent.
Oh, okay.
And he's in New York working on a film today called Cuttin' the Mustard.
Cutting the mustard.
Really?
Okay.
And we're very excited about him. If you go to our website and go to hair, click on the hair section, and then go click on Clark Vincent, you'll see his work. Out here in L.A., we have a makeup artist by the name of Kimbra, who is just amazing. And we're very excited about Kimbra. She's working tomorrow on the fashion spread for Interior Design magazine. And, you know, they only do that like two or three times a year.
Exactly. Wow.
So, and we've got a fashion stylist, oh my God, Edgar Revilla, who is just the bomb.
Okay. So now how?
And let me tell your listeners this, mm-hmm. because we obviously we don't have their email addresses, but we
right.
just did send out an email, and we are looking for hair, makeup, and fashion stylists in Atlanta and in Atlanta and Miami right now. So if they have a website, if they have any JPEGs of their work, and they can send us 2 to 3 JPEGs, if they have a resume, they can email it to Manuel, M-A-N-U-E-L, at crystalagency.com. They can fax us a resume or email a resume. Our fax number is 323-443-3752. It's our new e-fax number, so I'm trying to remember it. Because we are looking for people who, in Atlanta and Miami, who want to work on low to medium budget music videos. And we're trying to put together some teams of people because we have a couple of production companies that have asked us for that. So if any of your listeners are interested in, you know, submitting to us, you know, email us a link to their website, email us 2 to 3 JPEGs, no more than that. No more than 1 megabyte, because otherwise it'll suck up all the space on our
right.
server. But we're certainly open to seeing what's out there in the marketplace.
Well, folks, you heard it right here on the Hair Radio Broadcast Network. And, Crystal, I want to, well, you know, I don't even want to let you go. I want to answer one last question. What do you see, is there some kind of new trend that the fashion and the beauty and all of this, is there a certain direction that you see everything going into? Let's talk about, just briefly, just let's talk about that. Is there a certain trend that you see that's coming up now, or certain things that are kind of happening out there in the world of fashion and hair and makeup styling? Like, what's hot? What's really going on right now?
You know, the thing I try to tell people is I'm not really the person to ask about that because I really try to focus on the business end, and I leave I leave all the fabulousness up to the fashion stylist. But I will tell you this, it's really important for people who are out there wanting to work on in the industry to keep up with what's going on, and one of the best ways they can do that is going to InStyle.com.
InStyle.com
to keep up with what the heck is going on in the industry.
Love it.
And also to, you know, watch the shows. You know, they just had New York Fashion Week. LA
right.
Fashion Week is coming up. And keeping up with what's going on in Europe. It all happens too fast for me to be able to say, oh, well, this is what's happening in hair, and
yeah.
this is what's happening in makeup.
Right.
I stick to what I know best, and the only thing that I know is how to market and manage makeup, hair, and fashion stylists.
Love it.
My stylists come over here and tell me that I look how I look. You know, Crystal, you have got to change your hair. That is old. That is dated. Get out of those skirts. And I just do what they tell me.
Right. I hear you. Well, you've got the best people. So you're definitely in good hands out there. Well, again, I want to thank you so very much. I want to say thank you to Crystal Wright. And again, her book is called Crystal Wright's Hair, Makeup, and Fashion Styling Career Guide. And you certainly can. Now, what's the best way that they can get the book, Crystal? I do want to make sure they're aware of that.
They can call us here at 323-913-0500 if they'd like to order the book on the phone. Or they can go to our website, makeuphairandstyling.com, and they can order it there.
Terrific.
If they call and order the book over the phone, and I'll also give you our toll-free number for them to order, which is 877-913-0500. And they mention that they heard about it on hairradio.com. Then we will give them a gift certificate.
Wow.
For a percentage off of our packaging your portfolio and marketing workshops. You know, I have one coming up in New York on May 14th out there. We do it at the Mac Pro Store. We'll give them a gift certificate for a percentage off of our class.
Well, that is fantastic. And that's exclusively to the folks who are listening right now.
Exclusively.
Wow.
They will get a $25 gift certificate off the price of a class.
Terrific. Well, I want to thank you. And you've got to come back and tell us, especially a little bit closer to the workshop. I want to talk with you about all of that.
Okay.
And anytime, you're always welcome here at Hair Radio.
Thank you so much, Carrie. Thanks for having me.
My pleasure. Thanks again, Crystal Wright.
Okay, bye, everybody.
You know it's true.
9 o'clock this morning. We are experiencing some delays with some of the tracks, so definitely stay with us. If you hear a little bit of a gap, it's not intentional. We're not trying to make you wait for it. You know, it's just that some of the tracks are, I think it's the system, but we'll take a look at everything and try to figure it all out for you guys so we can work on it and get everything set up for tomorrow's broadcast. But we're going to stick it out today. As I was saying, the show must go on. I like that. Right, Michelle? Okay. Yeah, I like that. Mm-hmm. Now, so one of the big announcements is that, in case you haven't seen the Facebook postings that we've been making all over the place, we are so proud to welcome the one and only Miss Cece Peniston to the Hair Radio Morning Show. Now, you guys know her from her hugely successful hit song, Finally. And we play it often here on the Hair Radio Morning Show. And I've had the pleasure of interviewing Cece in the past, and I am so excited to have her back, you know, to get the Carrie Hines treatment, if you will. But this time in a new forum, she'll be on the Hair Radio Morning Show. So we're going to be talking about so many things, including her fabulous style. And if you want to read about her, we've posted a video or two, and I think you can connect to that. But certainly go to her fan page at hairradio.com. So we set up a little fan page to welcome Ms. Cece Peniston to our program. So you can go there and check it all out and kind of put a few things together there. And if you have some suggestions, let us know. Okay, or some comments or feedback, what have you. Wanted to take a moment to kind of, you know, bring in, I'm not going to be switching to too many different tracks. As you guys know, we just talked about a slight delay there. But this is one that I'm going to try to get on for you. Now, it's a little, maybe about 20-something minutes long, but it's with one of the other superstars who did our show recently, Mr. Gerald Austin from the Manhattans. And I'm going to see if we can get that underway, and I'll, you know, keep an eye on it for you. But, you know, we still have a whole lot more of the Hair Radio Morning Show to come. So stay with us this morning, and we'll get through all of this and tell you a little bit more about what else is going on. We do have some more updates coming, especially in the 8 o'clock hour. So stay with us.
Okay, there we go.
You're listening to the Hair Radio Show. I'm Carrie Hines. And we have a very, very special guest with us today. He's from the world of music. Hair Radio would like to extend a very special welcome to Mr. Gerald Austin. Gerald, welcome to Hair Radio.
Thank you, Carrie. Thank you very much. How are you?
Well, I'm doing great. And listen, I want to jump right on in. I want to tell the folks all about your wonderful current projects and some of the things, some of the highlights from an extraordinary career in music. So let's just go back a little bit. Let's tell the folks out there, Gerald. I mean, being a part of the legendary group, the Manhattans, tell the folks out there how you got your start. Like, I know you're from North Carolina. How did you get your start in music?
Well, I started singing when I was about 3 or 4 years old. And I'm from I have a musical background. My father sings, my mother sings, and my uncle Johnny Fields, the late Johnny Fields, was a founding member of the Five Blind Boys of Alabama. And so growing up, we constantly were singing, and we sang in church at an early age. All of us, we could go to church we had a church we used to go to called St. Andrew's. And all the kids in the neighborhood would go to the church and live in my neighborhood. And the ones that, it would be like 12 or 13, 14, 15 of us singing in church sometimes together. And we just started there and progressed. And then we're growing up on Sundays before we would go to church. Some weekends I would stay with my father's mother on the weekends, because my father's mother lived right down the street from my mother's grandmother, my mother. And so on the weekend, I would stay with my father's mother. And every Sunday morning, we'd have prayer, and we had to sing or say a Bible verse. And so she loved it, and we loved singing for her. And we grew up singing, and then my cousin Dwight, which is my Uncle Johnny's son, oldest son, Dwight Fields, we started singing together. We formed a group, and we became Gerald Austin and the New Imperials on Friday and Saturday. And on Sunday, we were the Gospel Jubilee. And we sang in church. We sang behind the Blind Boys. We sang behind Edna Gorman Cook. We did a lot of gospel shows. And then when I graduated from high school, and I started going to Kitchell College. And we had a group. We were performing there. I was going to college, I'm sorry. And my professor asked me could they use my sound system, because they had a group called the Manhattans that were performing there. So I said, sure. I went home, I got my system, set it up, and I was singing. And they came in and heard me sing. And I remember Richie Blue, the Hermie manager. Hermie, she was the manager, and Philip Terrell. He was traveling with the group. Philip Flood, actually. And I heard Richie say, this is a godsend. Not knowing that the original lead singer, George Smith, was sick. But he was traveling with them. And Philip was singing with them in case notice to help Smitty out. They heard me sing, asked me to be on the show. I sang on the show, they took my name and address, and they flew me to Dallas, Texas that next weekend, and the rest was history. I came back to New York, and I rehearsed with them for like 2 weeks. And my first show was in Richmond, at the Mosque in Richmond, Virginia, and that was 44 years ago.
44 years ago.
Yep, and wow. Group, and this August, the group actually celebrates 53 years.
Now, you guys went on to major success as the Manhattans. I mean, wonderful super hit songs, and I think you guys won a Grammy for Shining Star, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, 1980, we won a Grammy for Shining Star.
Oh, my gosh. Now, that along with Kiss and Say Goodbye, There's No Me Without You, and so many other songs. What did you get? Just tell us what that whole experience, like, especially like winning the Grammy Award. We will never experience that, most of us are out here listening. So tell us for a moment just what all of that's like. I mean, being at the top of your game.
It was, first of all, we didn't expect to win. We just said that we were thankful to be nominated. We were up against Gladys Knight and the Pips, Jackson, the Commodores, and the Spinners up there.
Wow.
And we just were just glad to be in the mix with them. And we were sitting there, and when they said our best duo group, the Manhattan, it was like I had to pinch myself, is this true? And we beat out all these famous artists, and we went up and it was unbelievable. It was a joy. It was a blessing. And I'm thankful to this day because it just showed that we were in the mix, and what we had done was not in vain. And we are recognized by among our peers. And it was an unbelievable feeling. Words can't begin to express how we felt and the feeling we had inside winning that Grammy.
Well, in addition to that, I mean, being nominated in the same category with all of those legendary artists that you mentioned, I mean, you've also been on tours and worked very closely with these folks, like Whitney Houston, along with Gladys and so many other folks. I just want to find out, you know, what has it really meant to you? Was there things that you learned from them, or maybe vice versa? Tell us what that, you know, what it was like, what you might have gained from having such great, great, you know, artists to be out there, you know, along with you guys.
Yeah. Well, you know, besides the mentoring that I got from the Manhattan, from Blue, from Kenny, from Sonny, Richie, those guys are wonderful. And Richie, unfortunately, Richie passed away. Sonny has been is ill. But Blue and Kenny are still with me, and I talk to them all the time. But in addition to those guys, the mentoring I received to touch my heart came from the Dells. Chuck Boxdale, Marvin Jr., Johnny Carter, Mickey, and Bernie. They were real from the first time I met them, and they were always real. Not that none of the other artists were real. They weren't real because they were. But the Dells were straight to me. You know, they told you, they mentioned me. It's like, I would sit down and talk to them, and they would, like, express to me different things. And words can't begin to express the lesson I learned. You know, they wouldn't let you get a big head, on top of which Blue didn't have it either. But the Dells, they kept you level. They told you when you sound good, and they told you when you sound bad. And, you know, and they told you what you need to work on. You know, the OJs, Eddie LaCroix, I love him. Eddie was one of the singing men I ever met. And
well, listen, yes, go ahead. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
I was just saying that working with him gave me, just watching him, I gained so much experience. And now we talk now, and then we share different things that we learn on the road from each other. But Eddie was a great mentor as well. You know, and Gladys Knight. She was an artist that was so secure. She's so secure with where she is. I don't care how high you are when you go on stage. She don't have to worry about it. So it's never, you know, how some artists, if they know that you're hot, they want you to cut your show or don't do this song. Gladys worshiped that. She said, come on with it. Come on with it. It made her work hard. And the Pips, oh, good God almighty. It was just a joy. I learned so much from working with these artists. And I'm just skipping around. But one of the most, I think the best thing that ever happened to me was the day tour we worked with Marvin Gaye.
Tell us about that.
He told me in Rochester Airport, I was taking him, I saw him there. We finished the show that night, and we were both flying home. And this lady wanted an autograph from me. She said, "Isn't that Marvin Gaye?" I said, "Yeah." She said, "Can I get an autograph?" I said, "I have." So I walked up to him, and I said, "Marvin, I'm Gerald." He said, "Oh, I know who you are. You one of the saddest singers I've ever seen. One of the greatest singers I've ever seen." And I already knew that from guys working with Marvin, my guys working at the group, worked with Marvin previously, told me that Marvin would never say nothing bad to you, but he, if you wasn't good, he wouldn't sit there and tell you you're great and knowing you weren't. He just wouldn't say nothing at all. And what Marvin Gaye told me, what he thought of my singing, you know, that was it. Didn't nobody tell me nothing then.
I hear you.
But I had a lot of experience and a lot of people I worked with.
Well, listen, this is just, you know, you're like an encyclopedia walking, you know, just a great resource that, you know, can help us and tell us so much about music and especially classic R&B. So I wanted to just get your feedback and talk about some of the current projects and things that you have going on. First, just let me ask you, what do you think of today's R&B music and the artists that are out there?
I think today's R&B music is slowly coming back around to real music, because for so long, R&B music was just a hook that was repeated. You know, but real music is coming back, and the artists are really singing. You know, and for a while there, I was anti-R&B during the early 90s and late 80s, because we had great artists that could sing, but they weren't singing no songs. You know, and in a lot of interviews and times we had a chance to express, we always would say, that's how we exist. That's how the Dells, the Manhattan, the Dramatics, Ray Goodman and Brown, all of us still exist today. You know, it's unfortunate some of us passed away, but the group is still there. Our music is still there. Music is bigger than the name. But the music is still there because we sang songs about life that people identify with. You know, we talked about making love, but we weren't graphic with it. We talked about making love, breaking up, coming back together. And it was, you know, and that's what's happening now. The artists are beginning to sing real songs. So I think it's a wonderful thing.
Good. Now, what kind of advice would you pass along to these artists of today? You know, you've been around for, you know, you've been out there for a while and having such a great impact on music as far as we're concerned. So what kind of advice might you pass along to some of these artists of today?
You know, I would tell artists today, keep God first, number one. And you have to be humble. You have to be humble. Because you, I don't care how big you are not doing your audience a favor when you go out there and sing. They're doing you a favor by coming to see you sing. They don't have to come and see you sing, but they're doing you a favor by coming to see you sing. So be humble, keep God first. And remember that, you know, they're the people that make you who you are. You go out there and you sing your heart out for them, give your best. And you know, be humble to it. It don't hurt to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning and go to the radio station and do an interview. You know, you might be tired, but get up and go, because those people are ones that make you who you are and who you will be. Stay away from the drugs, learn about the business, and be focused on the business and make it work for you.
Wow. Well, listen, if you just joined us, you're listening to The Hair Radio Show. I'm Kerry Hines, and with me on the line today is Mr. Gerald Austin. You guys know him as one of the lead singers of the group The Manhattans. And again, I want to welcome you to Hair Radio. It's a pleasure to have you with us, Gerald.
Thank you, Kerry.
Now, yes, now, the current project, what we want to tell everybody, first of all, your website. We must tell everybody how to get to your website, and then I want to ask you about some of the things that are going on right now.
Okay. My website is Gerald Austin, there, GeraldAustinMusic.com.
And, great. GeraldAustinMusic.com.
Right. And you can go there and you can get my new gospel CD. I have an EP with four songs on it titled Back to Basics. It's on CD Baby, or you can go to my website and get it through my website. Also have the Sam Cooke CD that I recorded back in 2008. It's a tribute to the late, great Sam Cooke. And you can also...
I want to get into this a little bit, Gerald. The gospel EP that you have out now and the songs that you have, and you're putting together a full CD for everybody to enjoy. Where did this come from? What was the origins? I know that you mentioned earlier about your beginnings in church, but tell us how this gospel project came about, because it's your first gospel project, am I correct?
Yeah. First of all, the gospel project came because it's something... I've always sang gospel. I've always sang gospel. I never stopped. That's my foundation. And I sing in church today, even before I record this album. I sing with my choir at Mount Fisker here in New Jersey, Mount Fisker AME. I sing there. But it's something I wanted to do. It was always in me. And when I sing on stage, you can see it. Whenever I perform, the gospel in me comes out. And so I wanted to do this. And when I did the Sam Cooke tribute album, I did both sides. I did his gospel music and his secular music. Al Goodman helped me put it. The late Al Goodman and Ray Goodman and Brown helped me produce this. We put it together. So when we showed the album to the record company, they said, don't put both of them out at the same time. Put the gospel album out later. And so I decided to do the gospel album. And so I just came back this year and added a couple more gospel songs to some of the songs that I recorded with Sam Cooke. And here I am. And this is what I really want to do. Gospel is where it is.
Well, I love the idea, and I believe some of the folks that we can expect to hear, like Regina Bell and Will Downs as well.
Yes, I did. I recorded a song with Will Downey, and I'm looking forward to that. Called Jesus is a Friend of Mine. And I've also recorded Irreplaceable with Regina Bell. And it's just unbelievable. God is so good. He's blessed me to put these people in my life to be able to work with them. And they're wonderful artists to work with. And we're looking forward to a great, successful gospel album.
Wow.
I was trying to get it out by the end of July, but it may be in the first or second week of August.
Wonderful. And everybody, of course, as long as we visit your website, we can stay on top of when it's going to be released so that we can rush and get it.
Right. And also, you can get it from my website.
GeraldAustinMusic.com. Got it. Now, go ahead.
I also have a Facebook. You hit me up on Facebook. And I have a Twitter account at GeraldAustin14. And so my fans are following me. All right.
Terrific. Now, I want to ask you about the Sam Cooke CD. I want to talk about that. I understand that he was a mentor of yours, but maybe you could tell us a little bit more. Why do an album in tribute to Sam Cooke?
Well, because Sam Cooke was my total inspiration. When I started singing, and I heard records by the Soul Stirrers, and I heard Sam Cooke sing, he touched me, because Sam sang songs that were for everybody. His diction, his songs all tell a wonderful story, and you can identify with it. And it's just the spirit that I got from him. That was the spirit. My father has the same spirit. My Uncle Johnny has the same spirit. And so it was there for me, and it was just perfect. And Sam was just right there for me. And when I finished the album, Sam's brother LC did the liner notes. And when I talked to LC, He said, you know, and I didn't know I had done it. I wasn't thinking of it that way. I just wanted to do it. He said, you know what's so good about this album? He said, you're not trying to out-sing Sam. You're not trying to sing better than Sam. You're paying tribute to Sam in your own way, in your own voice. And that's exactly what I wanted to do. I mean, I wasn't there to sound like him or to sound better than him. I just wanted to pay tribute to him with what God has given me. So Sam has blessed me with such wonderful music and spirit.
Well, I think you've accomplished just that. I was listening to a song that you had recorded, A Change Gonna Come, and at the end of this song, there was like so many different, you were calling out the different names of the artists who have passed on, and it was just an amazing song, and just well done. Just, yeah. Can you tell us, you know, what that has meant to you, you know, in terms of being influenced by some of those artists that you mentioned in that song?
You know, it's a wonderful thing to be influenced, because what happened is that I listened. You know, I never thought that I was better than. So I listened to those artists. A lot of times they didn't have to say a word to me. I listened to them. And different times I listened to them in interviews. You know, and they truly inspired. They truly inspired. And Change Is Gonna Come is a song I won the Amateur Hour at the Apollo Theater in 1966. You know, and mm-hmm. to give you an example about the artist, my wife is a dancer, and she was dancing in Reno at one of the hotels, the Harris Hotel, a show called Hotter and Hotter. And I went there, and Sammy Davis's wife, Alta B, was replacing the captain of the dancers. And so that was her first night. And that night, Sammy was there with his wife. And we were in the green room waiting. When the girls came off stage, all the dancers came around. We sat around Sammy Davis. And this man gave us some jewels that you could never, we wouldn't get in a million years. And he knew who I was when I got ready to do this. Myself to him. And he started talking. And he said, what he spoke to me was about humility, being humble, and being gracious, and be careful what you say when you say it. He said, love everybody, regardless, you know, how you feel, love everybody. And he said, if you don't want to be bothered as an entertainer, you can stay at home. You know, so many times he's eating dinner that was cold because he went out to a restaurant. And people saw who he was, they wanted autographs. He said he talked to TV and he autographed. He talked to him. He shook hands. He said, but when he wanted to have his personal time, either he would go to a private restaurant, private room, or he could just stay at home and have dinner. But when you went out when you went out in public, you had to acknowledge that they were who you were there for once they started talking. And things like that I've learned from him. I've learned from Gladys, I've learned from Eddie, I've learned from Chuck Boxdale and Marvin Jr., Johnny Carter, Pop Charlie Action. You know, these are the people that gave me some jewels. And I'm honored to have been in their presence. And that's why I am existing 44 years today, and that's why the Manhattans have existed 53 years.
Wow. We just want to remind everybody to make certain and to get a copy of your gospel music that's out there. And, of course, to go to your website, GeraldAustinMusic.com.
And I meant to tell you that the album is called Back to Basics. And the single on it is Back to Basics. It's a collaboration with Mel Holt, saxophonist, and Stella Award nominee Mel Holt. He produced it, he's great. And Travis Milner has been with me, the maestro from the very first album, and he's also performed and played with Manhattan. So Travis has been with me for years.
Yeah, you're working with the best out there.
Oh, yeah.
So this is fantastic. So what's next for you? What would you like to do? What's next for you?
Well, first of all, before I go into that, I'd just like to let you know that this year, we're celebrating 53 years. We'll be at Sculler's Jazz Club August 8th and 9th. And we're celebrating there. We're inviting all our fans to come out from all over. Just come and celebrate that night with us. Two nights are there, the 8th and 9th of August. And we're celebrating our 53 years. Also, September the 13th, we'll be at the Birchmere in Arlington, Virginia, Alexandria, Virginia. We're going to celebrate it again. So please come on out. We're going back to sing all of our old songs. We're just going to have a wonderful time. So please come and celebrate, because we could have not made 53 years without you. So we're inviting you to come out and share this time with us.
Sounds great.
And what we're doing now, we're just touring. I'm finishing up my gospel album. I have my two sons singing on it. In fact, I was recording my baby son, my youngest son, night before last. He's done a great job. We're going back to finish it. And once we finish it, the complete album will be finished, and we're releasing it, and we're going to move forward. It will be on the website. It will be on iTunes. It will be on CD Baby. So we want to make it happen.
Well, listen, my dear aunt would never let me let you go without doing a shout-out to Miss Jan Wofford in Jersey, and she's your biggest fan, Gerald. And
I want to just give her a shout-out, and I want to do this for her. There's no house without a home, and there's no man who wants to be alone. There's no child without a dream, and there's no song without a meaning. That's how I know. There's no me without you. And that's the truth, Jane. God bless you.
Wow. Well, listen, I'm sure she will just love that. Okay, so that's for you guys out there. Listen, I want to just say, you know, we know that you will be singing, that you will be continuing on with your amazing career in the music world, and the joy that you're bringing to so many folks out there, and the happiness, and, you know, to all the fans around the world. We just want to say thank you, and I certainly want to thank you for being with us on the Hair Radio Show. Just extraordinary career, and we're just going to stay focused and keep seeing.
This has got to be the saddest day of my life. I called you here today for a bit of bad news. I won't be able to see you anymore because of my obligations and the ties that you have. We've been meeting here every day, and since this is our last day together, I want to hold you just one more time. When you turn and walk away, don't look back. I want to remember you just like this. Let's just kiss and say goodbye.
I had to meet you here today. There's just so many things to say. Please don't stop me till I'm through. This is something I hate to do. We've been meeting here so long. I guess what we done, oh, the wrong. Please, darling, don't you cry. Goodbye. Many months have passed by.
I'm gonna miss you.
I'm gonna miss you. I've got ties, and so do you. I just think this is the thing to do. It's gonna hurt me, I can lie. Maybe you meet another guy. Understand me, won't you try. Let's just kiss, say goodbye.
You're listening to the Hair Radio Morning Show. I'm Kerry Hines. Now we have a very special guest with us today. His name is David M. Now he is a songwriter and producer, but you'll know him from this wonderful world beat song called Lest We Forget. The Hair Radio Morning Show proudly welcomes Mr. David M. David, welcome to Hair Radio.
Hey, Kerry, great to be here.
Yes, well, we're happy to have you here. Now, David, I want you to tell everybody about this great song, Lest We Forget, and the importance behind it.
Okay, Lest We Forget was inspired by two things, Mandela and Biko's fight in South Africa early on, and of course, the 50s and 60s, the struggle in the United States and in the world for black people, for equality, for civil rights. It encapsulates the fight and the commitment and the determination of Malcolm X and Martin Luther King, Rosa Parks, and those people in the 50s and 60s in the United States who worked to get us where we are today, the Civil Rights Act and, of course, the equality we enjoy today. But it was a worldwide struggle where blacks realized they were second-class citizens and refused to accept that. Unless We Forget encapsulates that struggle and tries to honor the people who got us to where we are today. And that's what it's about.
Wow. Now, this is, I think you kind of mentioned a little bit, that it was written in 1994 on the eve of
originally
the inauguration.
Originally, Mandela.
Yes, originally. Yes.
Mandela in South
yes.
Africa. But when Obama became president, again, it became prescient. It became something that we wanted to present. We redid some of the words and the structure of the song to celebrate not so much Obama's presidency, but to celebrate the fact that we had got from those times in the 50s and 60s to where we are today, we could have a black president. So we redid the song and restructured the song, recorded it. And Lest We Forget of 2008 is a new song, different song than the written song in 1998.
I see. Okay. Now tell us, how was this new song, how has it been received?
It was received very well at the time, of course. I think people felt that feeling of conquest, of having achieved, and it was well received. We used it, or we were asked to use it by the King in New York City for the Martin Luther King Awards. We were asked to play at many venues during that time, during the inauguration and after the inauguration. And we felt that, that the song was well received by many people, appreciated what the song was trying to say and what it encapsulated, what it represented for black people having achieved some amount of equality and recognizing the work of the people who made it happen. So it was a good time for us when the song came out.
Absolutely.
Certainly now, David, it's relevant today because some of the same problems we have, yes, they're different, and racism isn't over. We haven't conquered in the way we wanted to, but we've certainly moved along.
Well, I certainly want to get into all of that with you. I see, and I certainly have read some of the information that you you kind of point out some of these recent spate of folks who have been so, directly, shall we say, who've been in the news in terms of, alleged police brutality and all kinds of interesting race, elevated racial issues and so forth. So I think the song that you have created, I think it kind of really speaks to all of that. I want to go back, though, David. Let's go back. Tell the folks where you are from and how you got started.
Okay. I started music at 6 years old, playing the piano, and I played for orchestra in Jamaica. I'm Jamaican. I played for the youth orchestra in Jamaica when I was 16, 17. I played piano for it. By 17, I was in a studio recording. And in my 20s,
wow,
I was writing and recording for Gussie Clark, what was then one of the most prolific studios in Jamaica. I wrote for Gregory Isaacs, Freddie McGregor, Shabba Ranks, other Jamaican artists of the 90s who were very popular. Music was put on the back burner for me. I did law school and I took over the family business. And then in the 2000s, I got back into music writing for myself. And that's where Lest We Forget and the songs I'm doing came in. I decided I wanted to write probably more conscious music and mix, not just reggae music, but do reggae music, R&B, dance, and kind of fuse music together. I've ended up producing and writing for Beanie Man, for myself, and I'm putting out an album, which is coming out in the next 2-3 months, with Lest We Forget, Here Comes Your Life by Beanie Man. The name of the album is Here Comes Your Life, and it represents a mix of reggae, R&B, dance music, and represents the kind of music that I want to write, a mix of conscious music and dance, a little of everything.
And I think I saw a video that Beanie Man was in of yours, of one of the songs, if you will. Just outstanding items here. And this wonderful upcoming CD, if you will. Tell us how the fans of the Hair Radio Morning Show can find you and or pick up your music.
Okay, you can find me on davidmmusic.com. That's davidmmusic.com. Or you can find me on Facebook. That's David M. David M featuring Beanie Man, Here Comes Your Life, is already out on iTunes. Lest We Forget is also out on iTunes. The songs on it represent, as I said, some conscious music. There's a song on Haiti and why Haiti is where it is today. And there are songs that I think will tickle a little of everybody's fancy. It's a mix, as I said, of world music between reggae, dance, R&B, and we try to have a little of everything. I grew up in a background of orchestral music and really enjoy the keyboards and really enjoy the richness of music. We'll try to fuse different genres together. And I think we've kind of succeeded in giving you an eclectic mix of music from both the Caribbean and the U.S.
Well, it sounds like you're doing just that. Now, in terms of being successful, we're so happy that you're off to such a, an extraordinary career here. What can you tell the other folks who are looking to follow in the great footsteps of David M., the songwriter, the producer? extraordinaire. What can you tell those folks?
To stick with what you like. I mean, a lot of times you get caught up in a genre because it's popular. I did some of that back in the 90s, but at the end of the day, you have to come to do what you like and what you enjoy doing. You'll have a richness of a career and you'll have a richness of enjoying the experience in doing what you enjoy doing. For me, because I grew up doing classical music and I lived in Jamaica, which had reggae, and I was exposed to the U.S. I was in the U.S. for a couple of years doing music. It's really a mix for me, and that's what I enjoy doing. For somebody else, their experience will be different. Don't try and fit into what people want you to fit in, but do what you enjoy doing musically and artistically. And that's the best advice I could give anybody.
Well, that's the best advice to receive. Okay. So your new CD, you did touch on it a little bit earlier, and you said that folks can expect a big mixture of a variety, shall we say, of music to pretty much match what, you know, the taste that folks have out there. What are you hoping that they take away from all that you're doing with your socially conscious music? What are you looking that folks take away from all of this?
I'm hoping that people will appreciate the musician for what he represents, his experience. Funny enough, I was watching the Academy Awards last night, and I think they showed Marquez or something came up with a great writer, Gabriel Marquez. And I remember reading his 100 Years of Solitude and Children of Sanchez and hearing Chuck Mangione, who did the album for Children of Sanchez. Uh-huh. And melded music with great literature. And for me, that's what I want people to take away. That here was a guy who didn't just do what Jamaica was doing or what U.S. was doing, and Chuck Mangione the same, but who did what he thought musically or artistically was what he was comfortable with and what he enjoyed. And I want people to enjoy it for that, for the mix that we have. Music, to me, isn't static, because you do hip-hop or you do dance hall. That doesn't mean you can't cross over. And for me, very much.
All right. You're listening live. I want to thank Mr. David M. I'm Carrie Hines. And this next interview, and again, we're live. It's March 3rd, 2015, 8:12 in the morning, folks. Just wanted to thank you so much for being with us today. And this next interview is Miss Peggy Dotson. Now, this was done around the time of celebrating Dr. King Week. So if you hear any reference in there to that, that's what that's about. But she is an extraordinary broadcasting person in her own right. She has a lot of great information to share. So let us know what you think following the interview. Certainly, you know, you can always use our hashtag, AirRadio20, and let us know, or just send us an email or any of the regular ways that you engage with us at Hair Radio. So, again, this is Peggy Dotson, who is the broadcaster with her own extraordinary career out there. Stay with us. You're listening to the Hair Radio Show. I'm Carrie Hines. Now, today we have a very, very special guest with us. Her name is Peggy Dotson. Now, she is the woman behind UBC TV Network. The Hair Radio Show would like to welcome Miss Peggy Dotson. Welcome, Peggy.
Hey, Carrie. How are you?
I'm doing great. Well, listen, first of all, it's great to have you here. Now, we need to tell everyone what the UBC TV network is.
Okay. First of all, Carrie, I'm so excited about being here. I am your fan. I think you're awesome. It's just really great. Well, UBC TV is actually, it started out as a concept for a TV network, but it has evolved into a broadcast multimedia company with different divisions and things like that. So it's sort of like a hybrid between a cable network, broadcast network, and a technology company, online company like a Netflix. So it's sort of like my own creation. Because of where we are in the industry, you know, cable is there, but it's not there like it was before. People are unplugging. And so
so people need to want the opportunity to view things on different platforms. What, by the way, which I have, you know, I'm well ahead of my time because I was pushing this years ago, and
many years. We're not going to say how many.
It's true. I know we don't want to say how many, but you know, and then people want you know to see original content. Content is still king and queen. So that's what basically we're all about is original content that is distributed over multiple platforms, including you know online live streaming on demand, cable, live events. And different other little, you know, arms of it, which I think we'll get into as we move forward. But yeah, but that's what it's evolved into, not just a network,
terrific.
But more than that. Yeah.
Wow. Well, you know what? We are going to get into every facet of this, Peggy. We really are.
Okay.
But let's go back a little bit. Let's start at the beginning. Now, share with our fans that they tell everybody where you are from. And where you take care of business these days.
Okay. Well, the planet Venus. No, I am actually, I sometimes feel like an alien. I'm actually originally from Arkansas, the great
Arkansas.
State of Arkansas. Yeah, Bill Clinton and Maya Angelou. I'm from Stuttgart, actually. Stuttgart, Arkansas, which is really in between Little Rock and Pine Bluffs. I grew up down south. And the first half of my life and the second half of my life, there's a third and a fourth part of my life that I haven't lived yet, so it's not over yet. But the next phase of my life I grew up in is in New York City. So, you know, I am from Stuttgart, Arkansas. My mother and father were entrepreneurs. God bless them. They're my mentors. My inspiration. They passed away. They are with me every day. My father was a master plumber, and he was that was revolutionary at that time because you don't have very many African Americans who are master plumbers in Stuttgart, in a town, Stuttgart, Arkansas, which was, you know, racially divided. And my father and mother had businesses that catered to white people. I mean, we, you know, at that time, like I said, in the South, I was growing up, you know, the civil rights era had started, and the Black Panthers and all that kind of stuff, but we still had a lot of racial division down there, and you know, so and it was very, you know, that's, you know, it affected me and helped mold me, and I started working with my daddy. I did a little bookkeeping stuff at age 10 in his plumbing company. And it just taught me discipline. And then at age 14, I was working with my mother. She, my mother had a restaurant. So we have a restaurant business kind of in our family. And I learned the restaurant business. I was on the grill cooking. I was waiting tables. And I answered the phone, you know, to take orders. And I answered the phone for my daddy, Dawson's Plumbing Company, and when the clients called and all that kind of stuff. So at age 10 up to 14, I was, you know, learning the how to be an entrepreneur. And it's so important, I feel, that we have to teach our children at a young age about money and entrepreneurship because it really has helped me it has helped mold and shape me and helped me to be independent, a self-starter, and helped me get through a lot of adversity that I would not regularly have probably gotten through the way that I have, and I landed on my feet, you know, because it does teach you discipline.
Yes, absolutely. I'm quite amazed when I hear a story like yours in which both of your parents were entrepreneurs and you helping out because it does. What that does, in my belief, is that it channels that wonderful, it just teaches you without having to have been taught, so to speak.
Yeah.
It's almost like osmosis, you know, it just goes right on in there and it's there. And you don't even realize it's there. And then, you know, as you start getting older, somehow it kind of harkens back to that great foundation and introduction and fortitude that you just happen to have picked up along the way. That you know, it's just I'm blown away by that something that you were able to get from your father and your mother. And look at the way that I look at it. Look at the legacy that you've been able to, you know, to continue.
Yeah. Also, my spiritual connection to God, and you know, my mother and father were very into the church, and you know, it has extended through me. I'm a very spiritual person. It has pushed me to expand and learn a lot about different religions and cultures and things. But mom and daddy, my mother was like the mother of a church, and she was a gospel promoter. I met the Mighty Clouds of Joy, Reverend James Cleveland, at a young age because my mother, she put on gospel. She was a gospel promoter. And my mother was amazing. I'm telling you, my father was amazing. And, they are both my, you know, so I learned a lot about that, and it helped me in my music, you know, because I have another part of me that's part of the music industry and singing and all that. And
you do have a beautiful voice for you guys out there. So maybe you'll give them a little treat, in a little later on in the interview today.
Okay. We'll see about that.
I'm putting her on the spot, everybody.
I know.
Yeah, but I have to tell you, it is amazing. And so these are things that are just, you know, like I said, they're quite remarkable. And all these wonderful things help to shape the experiences that you have, and that you have under your belt, and kind of pushed you towards this wonderful, extraordinary entrepreneur in your own right. And so we're going to get into that a little bit. So you grew up in Arkansas. And then your family kind of moved up north to New York somehow, and you kind of, how did that come into play? And then where did this wonderful inspiration for this wonderful network come from?
Well, you know, my family, I'm daring. I'm a risk taker. My mother did not want me to actually go to New York. but my father was an adventurer, and you know, they were still in Arkansas. I eventually moved to Texas, but there was one time,
a big difference between New York. We're going to be fair. Big difference between New York and Arkansas, especially probably in those days.
Yeah. Well, at the time, you know, I in Stuttgart, Arkansas, I did a whole bunch of stuff. I was like first runner-up Miss Teenage Black America for our region. Yeah, my mother put me in pageants, and I ended up singing a lot and you know, competitions and things like that. Like I said, at that time in high school, there was still segregation, and there was a group called the Ricelanders that I could not audition for because I was black. But so I couldn't get in there, but as far as vocally, I could out-sing all of them. I'm not bragging or anything, but like that. But my choir instructor, Jim Sparks, bless his heart, he took me aside and he taught me how to sing. I started out with Billie Holiday songs and things of that nature. And so I just ended up, long story short, doing a lot of stuff, and then ended up getting two or three vocal scholarships to University of Arkansas in Fayetteville. I got a music scholarship, a vocal scholarship. So I went there. I also got offered to go to West Point Academy at the same time. That same year, West Point became men and women together. It was just men, and they were letting women in because I was also very civically, I did a lot of stuff. I was student body vice president and girl state. So I got nominated for a lot of stuff. So I ended up taking the music thing because my family's very music oriented and all that. And went there, landed the head of musical shows and things like that. I was auditioned for a great a cappella group and got into that. So we ended up going a trip to New York. The theater group I was involved in. I was actually playing Mary Magdalene in Jesus Christ Superstar, and then I was in The Wiz. So I played Dorothy. I was in Dorothy and The Wiz, so we at the same time we went to New York, I was Dorothy and the Wiz, and Diana Ross was filming Dorothy.
In the movie, that's right.
Yeah, she was filming it, and that's the same year I met her, and we have a family affiliation, the Ross family.
Wow.
And from Detroit, my family on my mother's side is from Detroit, the Rosses, and so they work at Motown and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, so I wanted to meet Diana Ross. She was my inspiration. And I ended up coming to New York and on this theater trip and fell in love with New York and did not know how I was going to meet Diana Ross, but I was here and I found my way to Queens, to the studio there with a friend of mine. I made some calls.
Is that the studio in Astoria, Queens?
I found my way to Astoria, Queens, to that studio. And I don't know how I did it, but I told everybody that I wanted to meet Diana Ross. And I did it. And I took the train there. Never been to Queens before in my life. Got on the train from Arkansas with one of my friends. And we went there to the studio, and she couldn't go in. I was the only one that could come in to meet Ms. Ross. And so I got a chance to meet Diana Ross. I met Sidney Lumet, who's the famous director.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I met the Michael had just left because he was the Scarecrow. He had left the set, so I didn't meet Michael Jackson. But I met the Tin Man. I think it was. Anyway, I met the other guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, because Michael was the Scarecrow. I met the Tin Man. It was, you know, it was really awesome, and it was very inspirational. And she was
so.
Just
this
gracious.
Is when they were actually filming the Wiz.
Filming the movie. Yeah. So
now,
because they called her Diane, and I'm Diane, and both our middle names,
Wow.
It's just that for me, that was like a highlight of my life. I said, if I can go to New York City and meet Diana Ross, I need to move to New York.
That's it. Exactly. Well, you know what? You're absolutely right. Now, this is a full circle moment. It's just so amazing to me because one of our guests, who's actually on this week as well, is Hinton Battle, who played, I think he's won like three Tonys, maybe more.
Yes.
He played on Broadway in The Wiz.
He did.
The role he originated, the Michael Jackson role was the role that he originated. So shout out to Hinton Battle.
Yeah, hey Hinton, I know Hinton. Hey Hinton, this Peggy called me. Call me.
He is fantastic. Yeah. So yeah.
He really is.
I'm just blown away that that was during that movie. Now, what also was coming to be, it was just released that NBC television is going to be doing a stage version of, you know, a live program that they're going to be actually, you know, bringing back the Wiz, if you will, for the TV show, a live broadcast. They've been doing these big stage productions recently.
Yeah.
So it's the Wiz is going to get that treatment, and I am excited for anyone to take on that. Now, so your big inspiration, one of your big inspirations, so we know is... and she's inspired many, many folks, and I've certainly chatted with her daughter, Rhonda, but Barry and Diana Ross's daughter, Rhonda, in the past. But can you tell me, who were some of the others who inspired this great Peggy Dodson? And then we'll get into you.
Oh, my God. I have many people in different genres. Dr. King. It's an inspiration to me. And Reverend Jackson, who I've just read at the Wall Street Summit,
current
hold it. People.
We don't want to gloss over these wonderful folks and the kind of connections that that you felt with these folks. Now, talk a little bit about that. Let's start with Dr. King. You know, we are actually kicking off this wonderful celebration to Dr. King this week on the Hair Radio show, the Hair Radio Morning Show. We want you to just kind of weigh in. What has Dr. King meant to you, Peggy Dodson?
Dr. King, what he has meant to me, what he means to me, is the chance to be all that you can be in a place that is equal and just. And I feel that is that was his life, you know, starting with African Americans. And he and the spirit to move forward in all adversities with what you believe in and your faith in God, you know, despite anything, despite anyone, he had his conversation with God, and God spoke to him, and he went ahead despite what anyone said, because what he did had to be done, no matter if he knew that eventually his life, he had to forfeit his life here on this earth, but to have that faith and to accomplish, it's almost like what Jesus did, anybody said, he knew that he had to do and fulfill what God meant for him to do. And I feel that we all sometimes get off track, and it's human, and we all get off track on things. But, you know, the one thing that has kept me going in all of this is my faith and me not giving up through all adversity, because this is not for the weak of heart. This industry, whatever we're in, as you know, it is that we have the deck stacked against us as a people. We don't own our images as much as we should. Stories are being told about us that we don't control. And to be able to step up, not maybe against, I won't say against, but to step out with the powers that be out there and say, hey, this is your story, but it's not my story. And to not be fearful in saying that, it takes a lot. It takes faith, because it's very scary. Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, I just want to let the folks out there know, if you've just joined us, you're listening to The Hair Radio Show. I'm Carrie Hines, and my very special guest today is Miss Peggy Dotson. Now, she is behind the UBC TV network, and we're going to get into that very shortly. But I just wanted to ask you, Reverend Jesse Jackson. Now, there is a great picture of you and the Reverend Jesse Jackson circulating out there around the internet, and we have that great picture for you, along with a lot of information on you, Ms. Peggy Dotson. So if you guys out there are trying to reach Peggy, you go to hairradio.com, and you'll see all of Peggy's information right there on the screen, along with some great pictures. And I'm told, Peggy, that you have some special words of advice that you are sharing exclusively with the fans of the Hair Radio Show.
Yes, definitely.
So we want to get you guys following our great interview today. Absolutely, this will continue. So you want to go to hairradio.com and read all of that wonderful information on Miss Peggy Dotson. Now, I'm ready to get into all about the wonderful UBC TV network. So you mentioned that this is a television network, as we just indicated, but what does the UBC stand for?
It stands for Urban Broadcasting Company, which is so weird. It also stands for Uganda Broadcasting. I have a lot of, and you know, I'm so connected to Uganda. It's weird. It's weird. I love my friends from Uganda, and I have a lot of people from Uganda that actually follow me online, and they love, you know, what I'm doing. I'm very connected to Africa, but especially Uganda. That's the name of the company, is Urban Broadcasting. I didn't want to pigeonhole, and people may say urban does, but it's, for me, it's urban multicultural. It's about culture, and I think that urban has been defined by others or misconstrued as something that it is not. Simply urban is city and rural is country. So it's urban means city, life.
Oh, okay. So urban is not just some euphemism for black. Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
So urban
and that's how people categorize it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, it means different things. It can mean different things, but for me, it's about lifestyle. And when you look at it, our lifestyle is the lifestyle. Lifestyle is how you live, where you live, and that's what UBC is all about. And it embraces culture. So that is not a black thing, it's not a white thing. It's all us together. I guess you could say that.
UBC. I like that. So the U can stand for us. Wonderful.
Yes. Yeah,
now, Peggy,
definitely.
Tell us, absolutely, tell us about some of the wonderful projects that you're kicking off at UBC.
Well, I have actually been, this has been a labor of love for me. And, you know, you have to measure and time things correctly. As you know, in this industry, to do a network is very expensive, and it's not easy because once you get out there, you said, oh, okay, I've got 24 hours to fill. Oh, okay, I need advertisers. Oh, it's, you know, a lot of my colleagues who are out there now who are just jumped on the air recently, it's that they've gotten a lot of gray hair, you know, just by having
and
the stress of doing that.
Yes.
Yes.
I can speak to that
yes.
one.
You know, so my goal is to roll out, you know, to start the digital part, which I have started officially last year. We have a live stream channel that where we are getting ready. We have live stream, we have on demand, and we're actually getting ready to do something very special. We're getting ready to put out our whole lineup as far as original productions that we are going to be streaming. As you know, streaming is really big right now in NBC, Netflix, everyone's jumping into that world, which for me, it's you know, and there's still a major cost because you can't just go out and just do it anyway. You still have to have that broadcast quality to that in order to bring on the advertisers or the sponsors that you want to bring on.
Exactly.
So you know, you have to, what we're doing is the original productions that we will be either live streaming or streaming will be edited, and then from there we back into cable. So we will have, some things will just be totally online, and then some things will be shot for cable TV, which we are rolling out this year, this spring, actually. I mean, the date is close, so I've got to, like, blah, 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 say the date. And, but we will actually be in about 40 million households, and and we'll have channels, we'll have channel positions soon, because I know people want to know that. And I'll be making that announcement. We will be able to be on Time Warner, Comcast, and Dish Network, and DirecTV.
And you'll let us know. You'll come back and tell all the folks at the Hair Radio Show.
Yes,
okay,
most definitely.
Okay, so we can get an exclusive, guys. You've heard it right here. We're going to hold Peggy to that now.
Okay, that's okay. I would definitely do that. It'd be real. It's going to be soon. Sooner than later, it's going to be soon. But you know, that's, you know, what we're planning on doing, and. I'm very, very excited about the lineup that we have. The lineup for the live streaming, of course, is different than the cable. Some of them will overlap. For instance, we have a show called the UBC Mix, which is, I guess you could say, it's almost an evolution of Soul Train. I love, and it's a show I created. A lot of the shows I created, by the way, and over years and years of research and me, you know, years and years of research and marketing and all that, and TV production and what I've done with NCAA sports. And that's my background, is from live TV. So I love live television. I love dance. I dance a lot. I love house music. I love all types of music. But
I have to say, I'm not to interrupt you at all. I just want you to absolutely let the folks know, and I want to tell everybody out there, they're listening to you and you're giving them this wonderful information. I just want to remind the folks, you're listening to Miss Peggy Dotson, who was our special guest today on the Hair Radio Show, and she's been telling us all about UBC TV Network. Now, I just want to tell all of our Hair Radio Show fans, if you want to find out more about Peggy Dotson, you want to go to her pages and find out how to reach her and find out more about UBC TV Network. We're posting everything at the hairradio.com website. So that's www.hairradio.com. And there you'll see, we're going to hopefully, Peggy will put up some more pictures and all of this wonderful, these wonderful things that Peggy's providing just exclusively for our Hair Radio Show fans today. So we are so excited. and we're going to give them all the information. Now, Peggy, great. I have to ask you. Yes, now, we got a little bit into it, but I really want to drive this point home, and I know that you can do it eloquently. Broadcast television seems to be going through a metamorphosis. It seems to be changing in a way. It doesn't look like it used to look. There's a whole lot of, flack about it not being more representative of the folks when we go outside our door. So, So individuals are saying that, well, gee, you know what? We don't control broadcasting. And when I say we, I shouldn't speak for folks, but I think what the message is that they feel that the people of color and the people who are representative of the world, the broadcasting doesn't really speak to those folks by and large. However, the internet, the new technology seems to be controlled, so to speak, at this time by the masses. So is there some, big, disconnect between broadcast and internet or technology and streaming and all of that? Is broadcasting changing?
It's changing because it has to somewhat. The big disconnect, I mean, that's one of the reasons why YouTube is so big, because you have more control over what you want to see versus what someone else thinks you want to see. And the big problem with broadcast is that it's big.
You don't have any control.
It's
turning your channel.
Well, it's big, so you have large organizations that have different departments that don't even talk to each other. So they don't, and you have people who have major pressure on them to create programs because you have accounting people saying, this is not making any money. It's not really set up. You have big public companies who are dividend driven, and they're not content driven. They're sports. People understand sports. That's an easy one. The multi-billion-dollar business. Sometimes like Fox, that's what anchors is, one of their big anchors. And then you have American Idol, and then you have a formula. The problem with broadcast and cable too is the formula that's used in calculating what they think people want to see and what individuals go in front of the camera. You have a formula. Oh, you have a formula for a story, beginning, middle, end, and that is very predictable, but that's what people want because they feel that's what makes money. And then you have a formula for people that you have, maybe if you may have three white people, you may have one black person, it's gotten worse. I don't know. I don't like formulas. I don't even deal with a formula. We're out of the box. My goal is to be able to represent life the way that it is and not contrive it. Even with the reality shows, they're not reality. They're contrived. They're combative. And a lot of the producers do that because they feel they have to create, anger and animosity in order for that, in order for people to watch, and then advertisers sign on. And a part of that is true, but it's not all true. And we're not represented at all. And, and the time when we are represented, it's so contrived and controlled and stereotypical. And, I mean, there are some shows that I'm not going to say right now. It's just it's just like, okay, this is a black show, even with major producers that we know that do film, that when they get to television, they get into the formula. And they put this and that. Let's put some salt and pepper and some pasta and the this and this. And that's the recipe. And that's if you don't do that recipe, you don't get on the air. Mm. So that's the problem. There is a big disconnect, and it has to do with culture. It has to do with disconnect with color. It has to do with people who are in positions who feel they think they know who we are and they don't. who don't know the story. But in essence, they know, all they know is that we have the buying power, $1.1 trillion, and they want our eyeballs. They need the eyeballs in order to bring on Coca-Cola and Pepsi and Mountain Dew and KFC and McDonald's. I mean, those companies know about our buying power. But the word power, you say.
Yeah, I love that. The word power. That's where all of this and what it all means. And
yeah.
I think that, yeah, and I think you really, you have completely and eloquently stated what I believe is the disconnect. So going forward, we have the folks like yourself, UBC TV Network, Urban Lifestyle Programming, and you're based out of, you're based where? I just want to make sure
I'm,
we hit all of that.
Yeah, I'm in New York. I'm in New York City.
New York City.
Yeah. And in Harlem, which is the urban capital of the world. It's New York City, and we have a new base that we're building in Las Vegas, and I'll talk about that at some point. Yeah, we're going
terrific.
To be doing some really exciting things there with another division of the company. Yeah, we're based here, but we're a global company. We're looking right now. We have some productions that we're working on, a major reality show with a major celebrity that we're I can't announce it yet. Yes,
okay,
a major celebrity.
But you promised to come back
that we,
here and
yes,
tell the fans
we have a major,
of the Hair Radio Show.
Yeah, okay. A major celebrity that we're doing a deal with that we are going to. We're doing a reality show with them. We're going to be following them around, not just here, but we're going overseas. And so that is, you know, that's kind of like what, and some of the programs, the teasers and stuff will be available online. And the rest of it will be on cable. And that's what I like. I like going between, I like the model that I've created because it gives me the flexibility to do things online.
You're not just doing one thing only.
Right. I'm not just stuck to cable and I'm not just stuck, you know, on one, just online. It gives me the flexibility to go back and forth with a show, actually. You can take part of the show, you can put it online and take another part of it, you put on cable. That way you go back and forth and you hit different audiences by that way. And we are a producing network, which is very important. I wanted to say that, even though we are doing partnerships with other producers and production companies, but I am a showrunner and I've created my own originals, and I have a great production manager, Academy Award nominated production manager. He's done everything. Worked with Billy Joel. He knows music, he knows sports, and he's just awesome. So it gives us the ability to be a producing network, so that we can actually produce our own originals. We can create the originals, we can produce them and distribute them. And we bring in our own advertising and sponsors and things like that. And I have an agency that I'm also dealing with. But it gives flexibility for creativity, and that's what I wanted because I'm a creative person. I don't want to be in a box where, I'm just a cable network, so I just got to do this. And I love my cable people, or I'm just a tech, or I'm just online, so I just can't do this. No, I love my technology people, so I want both. So it gives us the opportunity to not only create wonderful kind of like reality shows, music events, things of that nature that we have some exciting things planned. I tell you, we are ready to step out.
You guys are
into
just
the spotlight.
Moving along. Now,
yes.
I do want to ask you, Peggy, being a successful person out there in business, what words could you say to someone who's trying to follow in the great footsteps that you have trailblazed in terms of broadcasting and setting up your own network and working just all over the country with folks? What words can you say that just might be that great little inspiration that someone needs about now?
There's a couple of things. My inspirational words is never give up. My Jewish godfather, who's passed away, Burl Walk, always told me, he says, Peggy, never, ever, ever give up. That is my anthem. The other thing is learn as much as possible about the industry that you're in. Study it, go to trade shows, find mentors in the industry, which is what I've done. I studied this industry. I met people in the industry, just like I did when I was in the music industry. You know, I went to Luther Vandross and I said, Luther, tell me about the industry. This is actually what I did when I moved to New York, and I wanted to to find out about the recording industry, which is a totally different industry, just being a singer.
Right.
I mean, people think I'm a singer. I'm not digressing. I mean, I'm a singer. I want to be a great singer. No, if you want to be a professional singer, that means you are in the business of entertainment. So you need to know about that business. And I just went to every person I could talk to and had them tell me about the industry. And that's how you learn. And then you get mentors in that industry that are, great people who have high position. One of my mentors, he's retired now from Fox, as Roland McFarlane, who is the only African-American executive at a high level at Fox in Los Angeles at Fox TV and Fox Studios. And he adopted me, I adopted him. And I would always ask him questions and ask him, do you think this idea could work? He said, Peggy, go for it. It's going to work because it's needed. So I always have mentors, even to this day, that I go to and to listen to and talk about things. And I see mentors and just research and just never giving up on your dream, but also just being flexible, because what you see now may be a little different than what it really ends up being. I've had to be flexible in my vision with UBC. Like I said, I wanted a network, and now it's really it's UBC. TV network, but it's really just one component of it. We have media, and we have a couple other, we have film. We can talk about the film division. I have a couple other divisions, and we have sports. We have some other things that have branched off, and we're also going to be building studio facilities. So, you know, it's a lot. It's turned into a lot. Yes, I do. And we need to talk about the shopping. You know, don't let me forget about that.
That's something that
I really want to discuss.
Yes, well, we definitely will. And folks, if you've just joined us, this is a very, very special interview today right here on the Hair Radio Morning Show. We've got a person who is just doing extraordinary things in the way of business and community. The Hair Radio Show is very, very proud to welcome Miss Peggy Dotson. Peggy, again, welcome to the Hair Radio Show.
Thank you.
Now, listen, we've been talking a lot about some of the wonderful business enterprises that you're involved with. And when we talk of UBC TV Network and some of the wonderful programming that we can soon expect, we have to get into the shopping aspect that is about to kick off right here on this UBC TV network. So tell our fans out there, tell the show fans about this wonderful idea.
Yeah, well, you know, one of the things that sometimes I think I'm just totally crazy, but that's all right, because my Jewish godfather said you got to be a little crazy to do this. But the one thing that I see things that are needed, and I try to move to create a solution for that, and that's one of the reasons why UBC has been gestating over the past couple of years, really gestating and getting ready to and slowly rolling out. And people say, "When are you rolling out?" Okay, just wait. I got something I'm working on here. But one of the things that I wanted to do, and I've always wanted to do, was to create a shopping component to my network, because I wanted to create something whereas I'm not like the other networks where I have to really depend on all the advertisers and sponsors. I want to be able to groom my shows, but I wanted to create additional revenue streams. And that will keep the company going. And so I've actually created Urban Home Shopping Network. It is a part of, it's going to start out as a show, and then we're going to actually evolve to a separate thing. But it is an urban QVC. It's for small businesses, women-owned businesses, and people of color who want to gain entry into the home shopping network arena. And cannot. I mean, as you know, Home Shopping Network and QVC they're starting to cater to smaller businesses, because small business is the backbone of this country.
Exactly.
it is the backbone of this country, and people need to really understand
right.
that. And I want to do my part to help the economy. And in order to do that, and to give opportunities to small businesses who actually want to get their products out on television or distribute it globally.
Well, so let me just tell you, Peggy Dodson, this is such
yes.
an extraordinary business that you have launched. So I'm going to just take a quick moment to inform those folks out there, you guys listening right now, that you can go to hairradio.com and we'll put all of Peggy's contact information there so that we know that you're going to be very much interested in being part of this wonderful, these upcoming projects and some of the things that she's working on now. So you'll just go to hairradio.com, our website, and we have a profile there with Peggy's information and all about how you can contact her to get involved. Peggy, I have to say to you, any final thoughts? You've been such a terrific guest with us on the Hair Radio Show today.
Wow. Well, you know, I'm my final thoughts is I appreciate you taking the, you know, giving me the time to come on here and inviting me. And I know that we could talk for hours because there's so much going on right now.
Yeah.
You know, my final thoughts is, you know, about UBC, go like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. We have, if you have any questions about new shows that we have, you know, you're free to contact us as an email address, or we are looking for, you know, new shows. I am looking for, for content. And, you know, if you want to join us or whatever, just, you know, like us. And we have to, all I can say is that we have some very exciting things happening and getting ready to happen. We are going to make a major impact in the marketplace.
Yes, you already are. Now, I have to say, Peggy, you go ahead. I'm sorry.
I want to say that we have a, I'm making my step in.
All right. You're listening to the Hair Radio Morning Show. I'm Carrie Hines, and I want to thank Peggy Dodson for her wonderful words of encouragement and advice and all that she's doing. I want to thank Miss Yate. Thank you, dear Yate, for being with us today.
No problem. It's been a pleasure.
And I want to thank all of our fantastic listeners, and shout out to the folks in Philadelphia who are always tuning in, and those in New York and all over the country and essentially over the world. And thank you, you know, for all of the support that you're lending to us here at Hair Radio. We'll work on some of the things here. We'll get things in order for you on tomorrow's broadcast. If you haven't sent us your secret word, do send it in now. We only have about 3 minutes left to do that. And it's just been a fantastic day. We got some great updates that we really couldn't get to today, but we will be talking about them tomorrow, and I also have some surprise announcements on some upcoming guests. So it's going to be an extraordinary Wednesday show. Make sure and join us starting at 6 o'clock Eastern Time right here in New York and broadcasting to the world. And I was just thinking, why not go out a little bit, give it a little kick this morning, and so we can get Tuesday off to the right start. We'll go ahead and end with Prince today. You guys, make it a fantastic Tuesday. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye, everybody.
Goodbye. Bye, radio fans.